Now we're going to talk about a 2020 ballot measure on the March 3rd California primary ballot calling for major reforms of the L.A. County jail system. Supporters of Yes on R have outlined abuses and scandals by the L.A. County Sheriff's Department, including multiple guilty verdicts in the trial of former Sheriff Lee Baca, as well as deputies charged with sexually assaulting inmates, moonlighting for drug runners, and participating in a non-sanctioned group called the 3,000 Boys.
Meantime, limited opposition of Measure R include concerns there's not enough treatment programs to serve the number of addicts and the mentally ill in jails, and there's already an Office of Inspector General to conduct oversight of the Sheriff's Department. Joining us now, award-winning actress and activist Natalie Portman. She's here with Patrisse Cullors, activist, artist, and the founder and chair of Yes on R. Ladies, thank you for being here this
Welcome.
Morning.
Thanks for having us.
So we explained a bit of it, but for folks that aren't familiar, give us a little bit of background and history on Measure R.
Measure R comes out of a movement of people who've been trying to fight for jail reform and sheriff accountability for over 10 years. We successfully stopped two jails from being built here in Los Angeles County. They were going to be $3.5 billion jails, but we need to go further. And so much of the work that we're doing with Measure R is to hold the Sheriff's Department accountable and to really call for adequate mental health care here in Los Angeles County.
Natalie, you have so many people, I'm sure, coming to you and saying, please support us. You chose this. Why?
Well, I live here and I care a lot about our city being the best it can be. And when I saw Patrisse's leadership on this issue, and after having visited many jails and prison myself in this city, which has the largest incarcerated population in the world right here in LA County, I was shocked by the way the mentally ill in particular are treated. It was not how I wanted my local government to be treating our citizens. And it's also not the best thing for our city. Of course, if you're working towards rehabilitation, towards helping people, you're going to create a safer, healthier environment for everybody.
Natalie, talking about her experience visiting jails, what are the oversight issues regarding the alleged substandard conditions in our LA County jails?
I mean, for years, there have been people who have died inside our jails, people who've been in our jails receiving substandard mental health care inside the jails. Many people, especially people with mental illness, are often handcuffed to bedposts. That is not a place for people who are vulnerable to get the help they need. And so much of our work in the last decade and then leading up to the Measure R when we win on March 3rd is to support people that are most vulnerable in Los Angeles County.
Sheriff Alex Villanueva opposes the measure. He says that many of the things you're asking for are already being done, among them in terms of subpoena powers. He says documents are already being placed online, some of the documents he can't turn over legally. What do you say to that?
I say that we have started reform in LA County, but we have to go much further. Unfortunately, the sheriff in LA County has opposed this measure, but I think it's a common sense measure that everybody should be on board for.
There's a major component in your support of Measure R, and it's the lack of mental health. You ladies touched on that, resources in the LA County jail system. Tell us about some of those reported conditions and what it is like for folks in jail that do have a mental illness.
I mean, Natalie has visited firsthand the Linwood County Jail and the mental health unit in particular. I don't know if you want to speak to that, and I could talk more about it too.
It was really shocking when I was there, and something that I was surprised about too was that the people who work there were saying we don't have the resources and the training to help these people. We're not professionals for mental health care, and a third of the population is mentally ill, and they end up handcuffed to tables or kept in cage-like cells without access to natural light outdoors, and you realize it's not anything that's going to help anyone get better. And then when those people are released, I mean, how is that helping our general population, our general safety, and certainly for their wellness? It's completely, I mean, no person witnessing it feels that that's okay. And mainly it's allowed to sustain because it's out of sight for us.
And we work with families every single day who their loved one ends up inside a jail cell because they're mentally ill. Mm-hmm. And those family members have said to us, why aren't we getting the treatment that we need? Why is our family being subjected to substandard conditions instead of going to a mental health treatment center? The reality is we do not have enough beds to actually service the people who are mentally ill in Los Angeles County. And so this measure is going to help support that and help support the work that we've been doing for a decade now.
My sense is you're not demonizing the sheriff's deputies mm-hmm. or the people who are left having to care
Absolutely.
For the mentally ill mm-hmm. when, as you said, Natalie, that's not their training.
That's exactly right. What we're doing is supporting the people who are most vulnerable, the people who did not ask for mental illness, did not ask for homelessness or drug addiction. People like that, those are our family members, our loved ones. They deserve care, and that's what we're asking for.
Also the rate of recidivism, right, where they come in and out.
Absolutely. There's a cycle of people in the streets, in the jails, and in the psych ERs.
Yeah.
And that's not a sustainable cycle.
Yeah.
Natalie, you wanted to say something?
Yeah, well, also it's incredibly expensive to incarcerate people. Mm-hmm. So, like, this is the amount of money that's being spent on this system that is not helping the mm-hmm. cycle that Patrisse is talking mm-hmm. about could be spent in a way that could actually help people and get out of this cycle.
All right. Well, thanks to both of you for coming in. For more information, you can go to voteyesonr.org. I want to thank Natalie Portman and Patrisse Cullors for coming in.
Thank you, ladies.
Thank you so much.